come and play with me. Run away with me. Just you and me.
Good morning. So we're in the train at the moment. We got muscle to get here. James ran over a rat and all the insides came out and looked like baked beans. It was so gross. Did you have a look at it?
I didn't even respond to me. Okay.
Are you alright now that you're in the train? A lot of drama. A lot of drama to get onto the train.
Stupid Americans.
Oh, no, they're stupid. First, I was stupid Italians. And they started speaking English. She was like, oh, she's.
Okay, you act like an Italian then.
Just getting some breakfast and James got some Fanta. He asked for Fanta and I didn't know what he was talking about. And she's like, ah, Fanta, Fanta. James got a donut. Oh, that looks so good on Jello.
I can't have that. It will make me sick.
Why? I can't have that. That will make me sick. After that, I still feel sick after that.
That you yesterday.
Yesterday.
Donuts. The sauce, the chocolate.
Yeah, but I feel sick. I feel after that rat. It's disgusting. I feel like I'm gonna vomit. I need something like this. Prosciutto. Like that. Something dry bread. We got some Naples, we just dropped our bags off at the hotel and now we're riding out for our underground tour. I love you all if we don't make it here. I love you all if we don't make it here.
You said I don't understand.
I said I love you all if we don't make it back.
Yeah, I'd much rather live in Footscray, which is, put it to you, the shittest suburb in Melbourne. It is. It's a crap of summer. I believe there. It's cleaner than here.
Oh my god, it's so scary here. It is the most scariest thing I've ever seen in my life. I've never been more scared in my life.
It's yuck.
It's just yuck. The people are scary. It's yuck, dirty, yuck.
Can't wait to go to Pompeii today. We had to walk.
We had to walk 20 minutes to our hotel. We gotta catch a taxi back. The hotel's good. The people are nice. Yeah. It's clean. It's beautiful. Like, it's old. It's old and like, yeah, it's nice.
Yeah.
So this is the Naples underground tour place.
It's an underground city that used to be here. And it's just Naples, in Napoli, that is built in that way.
Yeah, so it's a Roman.
I'm pretty sure it's Roman or a bit after, but it should be Roman.
Okay. Guys, we're just waiting inside now. But do you want to buy an orange from the orange vending machine? That's all they have. They just have oranges in there. How funny is that? Is it cool?
Yeah, it's real cool.
Awesome. So these are from the 4th century. Using this when they started in the 4th century, but they stopped using it because there was a plague, and they started again. They used it as a dumping ground for rubbish for 60 years, and they started using it again to hide from the bombs and just have shelter from the war. These are the remains of some of the belongings from some people who stayed here in the war. Rubbish here built up over 60 years after they stopped using them because of the plague, and instead of just getting rid of all the rubbish, they just concreted over all the rubbish. So this used to be 4 meters higher than what it is now, and this used to be an aqueduct.
Painted this to waterproof it with like vegetable oil and all different kinds of compounds. So this, it's just the transfer of water. This was a Greek city.
So this was a Greek city in the 4th century, yeah?
BC, yeah.
Yeah. That was before they used it for the war. That's when it was an aqueduct.
Well, and then they walked along this wall. From the wall, they cleaned the water here with the help of a long stick with a big net on the end of it. More or less like they did it with swimming pools. So you can imagine it was very superficial.
So this is one of the shortest rooms that were built up from the concrete. You can see the painting from the aqueducts from the 4th century over there on the ground. Sorry, people only stayed in here during the war, during the 4th century. It was only used as a water supply for the town of Naples. Wow. This is crazy. I fit in this perfectly. I'm not even touching the walls.
Yeah, sideways.
Are you sideways?
Yeah. The Greeks used, so they'd come down here, get all the stones out, and then send them up there. The slaves would pull them up, but they'd shape them down here. This is where the well used to be. They filled it up when the war happened, just to seal the place. And before the wells, it was just like a shaft to get the stuff down, and then they made it into a well for the aqueduct. Suggested that you could, the
this conditions was in the 90s after the war, that you can build things down here.
And yeah, you don't need to water them because it's such a high humidity. And it was correct.
Yeah.
You can grow them.
If you reproduce the sunlight, which is what those lamps
do. That's what they did, yeah. A tunnel that's 100 meters long. It's a little bit higher than the other one. But yeah, it's pitch black because they want to preserve it. So we're going to head through now.
Oh,
yeah.
Look at you. I'm really scared. It's so cute. Okay, I'm not any bigger. Yeah.
Did you make it out alright?
Just.
Yes, this is a simulation. Exactly with us. Well, up there, and they would, from up on the city, they would lift down like a bucket kind of thing, and they would get the water from there, bring it back up. So just a well here. Some more plants, proof that they can live here. Now we're heading over to see the Roman amphitheatre through these streets. The Roman amphitheatre is right below us now. So we have to go down. Could fit, 6,000 people here, which is massive. Yeah. That's cool, though. This is how that lady had for her wine. So the bed comes forward and then she pulls it up and it's a Roman column. So it was a hint that there was something Roman here.
And then I bought her out like 20 days ago so I could try and find
the should have been wrapped. Should have been wrapped up. This was plastered up here, and this was plastered up here. She didn't even know that this was here. And at the moment, we're in the backstage of the theatre. So the theatre is that way. So the seats would be, you know, like the D, like a theatre like that. So if I was facing here, the stage would be there. And I'll be facing everyone. So that's someone's kitchen. this bit here is the Roman bit, then the next one is the Middle Age, and then that's getting newer and newer. So everyone just kept building on top of it because they had no space. So they wanted to build within the city walls. Yeah, so that's someone's, yeah, someone's in there now. You can hear them when they're having that. There is an arch from Roman times that supported the highest seats.
That's one of the entrances.
Yeah. Also, this street curves a little bit because, like, it goes with the amphitheatre. This arch here is part of the top highest row of the amphitheatre. What else is there? This used to be a carpenter's shop, was it?
Yeah.
And those two windows and that window there are a B&B.
Yeah, car and bed and breakfast. And they, like, can't buy everything out to try and look at all the old walls and stuff because the modern house is so cool.
Yeah, so they can't rip down the modern houses and try to, like, get the amphitheatre out again because it will probably fall down. But yeah. Everyday life with a touch of religion in it. That's pretty much what you said.
Yeah,
in the Middle Ages, 1500s. Yeah, in the 1700s. Was it 1500s? Something like that, yeah. 15th century. So 1400s. On the street.
I can't believe. I don't know. Naples is just so funny. Like, people just have their clothes, like, up there, right, drying, but they just have it on the street and in little alleyways, like, their clothes and, like, clothes horses drying in the street with people smoking all around and. Huh? Like, a really nice street. There's all, like, nice cafes and food and stuff. It's really cool. But, I guess we'll show you how yuck it is when we go to the station.
What? It's like cake in a cup.
It's like cake in a cup with cream and stuff. That's so cool. Bon compliment, birthday cake.
Can't believe
we haven't
been in Italy for how long?
We haven't had a cannoli, and now we got one, and we got chocolate one.
So good.
Yeah, so
massive
excited.
It's a
big hit. Yeah, I know. Is it good?
Different. But good.
Very different, but really, really good.
That's all right, man. Thanks.
Oh, thank you.
That's all right.
There's like chocolate all on the inside. How yum is it? This is the best one I've had.
So good.
It's so good. We're just walking back to the hotel now. I mean, like, it's pretty bad here. It's what everyone says it is. But I just think if you mind your own business and keep your head down, you know, like, it's like, oh, you know, yeah, it's pretty much like everywhere. It's just a more yuck, you know. But I don't know, it's like, I think it's exactly what I expected it to be. You know, and the streets are really old and cool, like the, in the old bit, like near the station. Yeah. So it's all right. It's not, it's bad. And I'm glad we're only staying here 2 nights. And that we're going out of here during the day. But yeah, it's not as bad as I thought when I was walking past the station. I thought we were going to have to stay in one of those streets. We still haven't showed them what was near the station. Oh my god, I died. We're back at our hotel now. We've got 10 minutes until we can check in. But look, they're starting to paint all the walls. They've done a lot of them already, but there's a bit that they haven't done. But look how cool so far. How awesome is that? I feel like I'm in Alice in Wonderland. Huh? Oh yeah, there's garlic hanging on the wall. That's not paint. It's pretty cool. Looking forward to seeing Anna. Just checked into our hotel and it's the smallest room we've ever been in and the smallest bed. So it's like a double bed. At least we've got a TV and we've got aircon. It seems clean. And there's like a full length mirror here. And bathroom. Towels.
And then we're going to Pompeii.
finally got on the train.
Came like 15 minutes late.
And then changed like
platform. Didn't even see where the train was meant to be. Yeah. So much trouble.
They don't even tell you, it has a million people.
Yeah.
This place is retarded. Yeah. Like they don't, the train system is just retarded. People don't know anything. It's just, like Shamal's
on. You gotta get in a train. It's quite, look at Tony, maybe Arabic or something. When I was standing up, he walked into me and I was just looking at him.
Everybody pushes. Everybody pushes like it's a stampede.
So,
like,
so
even
the same
old
guy,
people,
the same guy that walked into me and didn't say sorry, I looked at him, he looked at me like, what do you want? Yeah. Walked into me and I just wanted to say sorry. He just looked at me. And then I tried to get in the train and he was pushing me. And then there's all like
pushing,
everyone's pushing
to get a chair, and everybody's got a seat except
and
for
then I got a seat, and then you walk past me and say,
you didn't get one. Everybody got a seat except for the people with suitcases who need a stand for their suitcase.
Yeah.
So everyone's pushing
for nothing.
It's so stupid.
It's funny, you push me and then I'm going to see it anyway.
Yeah.
That's it, and you got pushed too, and you got a seat.
Everybody got a seat. I think you've gone nuts about
it. Yeah.
It's just so funny.
I heard about the bushing and it hasn't been like that here.
No, it hasn't, only here is where you see everything. It's bad.
Just have to have the whole of each other.
Like, I think we're talking.
I would have lost it if I was
Yeah, I just wish all this stuff happened at home, so like I could just slip out.
Straight give it to you.
Yeah.
Walk into the straight away. I'm going to say in English. Are you going to say sorry?
Yeah.
I'm going to say nothing.
Yeah. And only that, you don't know what they're capable of.
Yeah.
Like, it's scary. So you just kind of let them.
Just shut up.
Yeah.
You do. Still, it's just stupid.
But still, we're talking, you're like, this is still our favourite country out of every country that we've been to so far. But it's not just the food, what we
food
do,
and the sides,
sides and all of that. And even sometimes, like, in the restaurants, like,
yeah,
the
sides. Yeah.
A lot of people are good, but, like, randoms are stupid. And it's like, the shit at all the countries, it's the shittest country. Like, people wise. Like dirtiness wise, like you know, cleanliness, you know, just feeling safe, like security. What else? Like the train system, like all of that.
Yeah.
It's the shittest country out of all of them, like unorganized, just crap.
Yeah, all the trains are being on time, will be good.
Whereas if, you know, yeah, whereas all the other countries, yeah, like, but still our favorite. Just got off the train to Pompeii.
It's gonna be like the real conditions of how it was, isn't it?
I know, it's all, and yeah, it's all dark and, oh, it's just starting to rain. Yeah, I told you it was gonna rain. I didn't bring my raincoat. Bloody hell, we just have to do it in the rain.
Walking through the entrance now. We just went past some baths. We're gonna hit them on the way out. They like the public ones. It's crazy. That's a crazy view. I imagine that would be Mount Vesuvius. I'll imagine it. Yeah, one of them. One of them that's bigger. So this is the port, the marine port. Yeah, apparently.
Just imagine it was lava.
What is
five basilica? So that is the Temple of Venus. There. And this bit here is the basilica, apparently. So nice. So this is the forum, like the one in Rome. It's where everyone met and all their temples are.
Oh, Sierra.
So there was the temple of Apollo. Yeah. This is where one of the temples would have stood. That one there is a temple of Jupiter. That would have been like a massive main temple in this square. Very important pagan god. It's actually like really smashed all down.
What?
It's really like all damaged, hard.
So was it only damaged just by that? Like just?
Yeah, it was damaged by like the force or lava. I didn't think it was lava, it was like gases and stuff. No, nothing else happened, no. Like barbarians destroyed it. No, it was buried. It was buried in all the dust. So this is the temple. It's massive. That would have looked really impressive, that temple, because it's the main temple. It's cool as. I wonder, I think it was called the mycelium. We'll have to definitely look up what that was. There's all posts in the middle, it must have meant something. We'll definitely look it up. The frescoes. That's cool as. Huh? There's none there. Nothing on this side. I wonder what it was used for. We have to find that out. Some pots that they found. Some more pots. I know. So there's a restaurant right there.
They just built it like
is the baths. That's cool, eh? Little courtyard. This floor's still original. This is the bath. That's cool as. That's good as. It's hot in here. This is probably the hot room. It's cool as. Another bath here. Can't really see a bath. There is. Oh, there's a bath here. It's like a skylight. What's that? I wonder what they'll use that for. Did they put that on top, like in the, and there's a bath underneath it? We're just in like someone's house or a shop.
It's rainy, it's really nice.
Yeah, it's cool. Oh, that's cool. That is the floor still there.
Wow.
And the fish goes too. That is cool as. We have to go in there, man. I think maybe this is a shop. It's either that. I can't remember what it was. I remember seeing this on a documentary. But like people would sit down and eat here. Unless it's tallest, but I don't think it's tallest because it's got like a thing. But yeah, I'm pretty sure it's a shop. So we're in that house that we saw. It's cool as. It's their courtyard. The rooms. This is cool as. So that's the impervium. So it's when you, the first thing you see when you walk in is that. So the water from the roof comes down. You can probably see to fill up the pool. Like many, well, mostly all the big places like this will have an impervium. And then it leads to the garden. The floor's the original, it's cool there. Apparently this is the bathroom. I'm not sure where you go to the toilet bar. Looks like a kitchen to me. Yeah, so it looks like a kitchen. I don't know if it's a bathroom. I'm just saying it's what they said, but my opinion, my expert opinion, is that it's a kitchen. I think this is the room where they have banquets and that, and I'd sit down and kick back. That's what I remember seeing. A clear view of it.
They ran out of pizza for lunch, so now we're having all of these desserts for lunch. Yum. So tiramisu, apple pie, donuts with cream. Yep.
Which is a very big ruffle, like the biggest one here, and it's like really good, like it's all kept good. It's the Lupinari Grande. So this is a brothel. I think they restored it. It's exactly what I saw on TV. So these are the pictures that G people up before they go in. There's one of the rooms, stone bed with probably straw on top of it. There's another room here. It's all like graffiti on the wall. You can't really see it. Here's some more graffiti. There's more graffiti on these walls. I don't think we can go upstairs, but from the documentary I watched, upstairs like a massive room. And it's like we're like, if you had more money, you could rent it out. Communal fountains everywhere. It's got like a face on it. They're led up to the water. I don't know, I think they're copper. Kind of like that other house, but this is obviously like doesn't have the floor in that. So that's the Empyrean, and then there's the garden after that with the columns. And all the houses, all the rooms that go off it. So most of the houses like were like designed like that. This is the triangle, the angular. This is a triangular forum. Yeah. And then there's a temple next to it. Temple of Isis. There's another temple here. It's a small temple. It's on top of it. Those are probably columns. There's a good view of everything from over here. It's cool. This is the Temple of Isis. This is a Roman god, I think. It sounds like it could be an Egyptian god too. Because they do mix all their gods up sometimes and have different cults of different gods and different places and whatnot. So we're sitting in an amphitheater. This is where people would have come to watch shows and like the politicians would maybe say some stuff down there. Most of the time it would have been, yeah, some like plays and shows and whatnot. It's really cool to be sitting here like they would have been watching a show. That's what it looks like from down here. The whole thing would have been marble. It would look really impressive. This nice courtyard. It's a little mini one.
Wow.
It's cool, that's like a little courtyard thing. Here's one of those. Pretty sure it's a shop, man. Here's another one of those shops.
Yeah.
This house is cool, eh? Say, look. Yeah? They have a sunroof on this. This is the impervium again. So there'll be a lot like a water there. It comes from up there when it rains. This is probably a shop because of that thing there. There's probably some shops here. This is where they'd come and eat lunch because they didn't make food at home. They'd come here and eat. Thank you. Yes, I was right. Those holes had food in it. Told you. This is where people would come and eat, like a cafe or the other. This was a bedroom for the people that own the shop or cafe, whatever you want to call it. So this is the room where they'd have feasts, like lying down like the Greeks did. Yeah, this is like all these shops and that. So these will be all the shop fronts. Sorry. Okay, there's another restaurant. This one still has the original doors. Sounds cool, lad. See how big their bath is, the Emporium. Unless they made it. No, I think it was a bath. Because that ground looks like all tile and that. This is the big stadium back here. Yes, over there. Here's the stadium. It has a massive wooden pyramid in the middle of it for some stupid reason. Through the stadium and the stairs leading up to where you want to sit. How cool is that? What was that? Yes. Oh, that's cool, guys. An oven there for sure. That's cool, it's like a double story. They got the wood there. Maybe this whole thing, maybe that was the upper floor. This is sick. There you go. There's a body. A kid. The big casing. I feel like I'm in Bunnings. Just all the pottery scattered everywhere. I wanted to actually like put it somewhere. Like a display it properly. And all these things on the top.
It's so disrespectful.
There's that man that was cowering, praying or something. There's that famous one. That's a dog. It's a dog. Because it's probably stressed out. Can't see because it's light.
Yeah.
It's like directly on it. There we go. I wonder what that is thing. That thing's there.
Hmm?
I wonder what that's for. Maybe the dog's house. On the main square forum. Designed to of the horses. What are they? Horses' heads, are they?
Perfect, bulls.
And bulls. Sick. On one of the pillars. Temple. Can't really see it. Shook up my arm for the other one. It's sick. There's like a statue there. It's really cool from here. What's that? Really good picture. This would be the entrance to the city. Colours are sick. Okay. All the colours they use are mad. Like the red, the touch of red in their room. This place that's like right out front of Pompeii. We just really want pizza.
It's really not CBF.
Yeah, we're CBF going all the way back to Naples and then like not finding what we want.
Yeah, and then having going in that yuck street and probably things are closed, like yeah. It's just a little like cafe type.
Yeah. So here, there's no,
I don't
no stress. Just go, yeah. Yeah.
I think we'll take away in that. This morning on that tour.
Just take away bread shops
and
like cannolis and that.
Going there, yeah. Go to the hotel.
Yeah. Look at those massive lemons here. We've got lemons everywhere. There's a lemon on our table, but those are massive. There's a lemon here. But I've got a lemon beer, so just embracing all lemons. Killer, man. Ah, yeah. Killer. Hopefully we have it in Melbourne. People here are a bit freaking stupid. But when I walked in to ask the guy if he had pizza, he didn't understand me. I said, do you have pizza? But I don't know what you're talking about. That's like someone coming to Australia. Because I'd say, pizza. Pizza, yeah? It's like someone coming to Australia and saying, I want pizza. And I go, I don't know. What are you saying?
Yeah.
How would you not know what I'm saying? I'm just saying it differently. Pizza, pizza. So when I say pizza, he understands straight away. If someone came to me and said pizza, I'd be like, yeah, fair enough, pizza. You want pizza? I wouldn't be like, I don't know what you're talking about. So I'm not saying complete different words. This is retarded.
Pizzas look so good.